Hello children, welcome to our 8th social class. Children, today we are with to again another new topic, that is ancient civilization of world, because we have seen how the civilization has been flourished. In the previous lesson we have seen what is civilization, especially the civilization of India, isn't it children? And there we have seen how the origin or the historian, they excavated the things regarding the civilization, isn't it children? See, we have seen that the bricks, mound bricks which they got during the time of laying the track, on the basis of that track, when the excavation went on, they came to know that in particular place called Meharga, the civilization has been founded. The place Meharga, you may be remember, isn't it children? That is very fertile land. Why it is a fertile land? Because of the fertility of the river which flow over there, which make the place Meharga as a fertile land, isn't it? On that basis, we are came to know that where the civilization has came into establish, or which place made to rise of a civilization. It is on the river bank. Where the river bank is available, there we can notice the establishment or the flourish of a civilization. Because I told you that, you may be remember, civilization is a form where people are turning into uncivilized manner to civilized manner, isn't it children? Where people are living uncivilized, or they are following wandering life, in the sense that moving from one place to another place. In the form or in the beginning of a civilization, you remember, maybe remember, that they have started to dig a pit. Pit in the sense a big hole inside the earth. They used to live inside the earth. Then they started to settle down in one particular place and they adopted the occupation, isn't it? They mainly adopted the occupation as agriculture. Then they are introduced, or they adopted animal gazing or animal husbandry, farming, dairy farming, such kind of the occupation they are adopted. Then the next form of the occupation was artisan work, isn't it children? All this we can see in the civilization or civilized form of our life. There we also noticed that in the one side, whereas you take example of a Sindhu Valley civilization, where in the river of a Sindhu, Indus Valley civilization, the flourishment of a civilization. Another side, in another river bank, there is another civilization. It doesn't mean that only one civilization, after the end of that civilization, another civilization will fall. No, it is not like that. In entire part of the world, we can see the rise of a civilization at the same time in different part of a country. It is example as that. For example, now here A section class, social class is going on. Clear children? Another side you may take, in the B section there is a math class is going on, isn't it children? So at the same time, both A section are attaining two subjects, isn't it? In the same way, civilization is where it will take place. It took place in entire part of the world at the same time, or it may be in a other time. But here we are referring civilization, especially the ancient civilization of a world. World refer to wherever the civilization has been took place. So today we are specially referring about Egyptian civilization. I hope by seeing all this you are curious that what is Egypt. The Nile River, it is symbolized of Egypt, isn't it children? You are well known. I won't tell you that you have seen, you heard about the river called Nile River, isn't it? It was very famous, and in the word, all this which indicate the Egyptian civilization. So children, let's move on with the topic Egyptian civilization. The Egyptian civilization is very beautiful. Why? Because you may have heard the topic called pyramid, mummy, all this you may heard, isn't it children? So here it attract Egyptian civilization. So how did that civilization, Egyptian civilization, as came into existence. How it has been came into existence? What made it to come into existence? It is none other than Nile or the Nile River. Nile River, which brought Egypt civilization into existence. How in the sense, this is a Nile River or the Nile Valley, which gave the establishment of a Egyptian civilization. How in the sense, mainly the Egyptian are the peasant or the farmer or the agriculturist. Clear children, the main occupation is agriculture or the farming. So when the Nile River, during time of a rainy season, the valley turned the river into huge lake. Is it clear children? During the time of a rain, the Nile Valley, which turned the valley into huge lake. Clear? After the rainy season, that where the lake has been created, that lake place has turned into fertile land. Is it clear children? Where the place which has become a valley into huge lake. After the end of a rainy season, when the river will come down or the flow of a water will come down, then the place where water has remained, that place has itself become into huge land, which is suited for the cultivation as well as the grazing. Is it clear children? So that land which turned into agricultural land, which is very fertile. It is that, how in the sense, suppose if you get a one particular place of a land, listen carefully children, you want to do the cultivation. So for the sake of a cultivation, a particular piece of a land, you will convert that into agricultural land. Is it clear? The particular place of a land, you will convert into agricultural land. How you will convert into agricultural land? You will remove the waste from those land. Isn't it? Whatever things which is not needed for agriculture, if you found on that land, you will remove that and you will make land as a even land. Isn't it children? You will make it as a flat land, which is best suited for your cultivation. After that, what you will do, if the soil is less, you will even provide the soil so that it can be used for the cultivation. Isn't it? That is what we are doing then. Then if you notice that the land which is less fertile, you will supply the fertilizer to that land. Why? Because when you provide fertility to the land, what will happen? You can get the good crops, you can get the good yield. All this work has to be done by us. As in the sense, human beings should be do all this to make the land as a fertile for the purpose of a agriculture. Then only you can do the cultivation on the land. Isn't it children? But here the Nile River, what it has done, during the rainy season, the river will turn into huge lake. After the rainy season, the river itself made the land as a agricultural land. Instead of a work of a human being, where 100 people is needed to make a land as an agricultural land, here a single river, children, is it clear? A single river alone made that land into fertile land. That was the greatness of a land. That is why children, we have to respect, we have to protect the nature where it has made the work of a human being less. What the work that human being has to be done for the purpose of agriculture, here the river itself made or presented that fertile land to the Egyptian for the sake of a cultivation, so that the Egyptian consider that Nile River as a sacred river, because it has gifted the land to the farmer for the sake of a agriculture, so that when the vast area of the land which was available for the cultivation, the people utilized that land for the sake of a agriculture. So the civilization, Egyptian civilization, has been started because of the contribution of a Nile River. Clear children? So when they have started agriculture on the valley of a river valley Nile, they are remained in the one particular place. They started doing the agriculture. Then as I told, they are the prosperous, they are the well-known farmers or the peasant, their main occupation was what? Cultivation or the agriculture. Then in the leisure period, the peasant has to do the work of a artisan work. Artisan in the sense weaving, pottery making, all such work has been done by the Egyptian. It shows that they are people of hard work. They doesn't sit quiet. After the end of the agriculture or the farming, in the leisure period, what they has to do? They has to engage themselves in artisanry or artisan work. Is it clear? Then the how the life of a people. The life of a people where the priest. Priest, the role of a priest is what he has to do. Nowadays, what is the role of a priest? We have seen during even in the Vedic period, he has to perform the yagnas and yagas. Here, what is the role of a priest? The role of the priest is that he has to interpret and the worship of a nature. He has to tell, in the sense he has to explain, interpret it, the meaning and the importance of a nature, so that he has to tell what is the importance of a nature. Without the nature, how the human being will suffer. All the importance he has to narrate to the common people, so that he has to make people aware about the about natural resources. That is the main work of a priest. And here mainly remember children, here people believed in the concept called life after death. Is it clear? Here people are believed the concept called life after death. What do you mean by life after death? It means that they believed another concept, that whatever deeds we are doing on the earth, for the fruit of that deed we have to suffer here itself on the earth. What does it mean? It means that suppose in this birth, if you are doing a good in this birth, that good deed return you will get on this birth itself. It means that you are born now, you are doing a good to the others, that good deeds will reflect good to you in return. If you are doing a bad, that again that bad will reflect on your life in this birth itself. That is the belief of a life that Egyptian believe. And what is this Osiris? Osiris is a god which is a god of life and death. So this god will keep an account of your good deed as well as a bad deed. What is the work of a god Osiris? Here Osiris is a god of life and death, who will keep your record of good deeds as well as a bad deeds. This all the concept were taught by priest, so that people will be aware of the good moral and good conduct. Is it clear, children? So that is one thing. And I forgot to tell you that here, after the establishment of a rise of a Egyptian civilization, historian has got the sources or evidence regarding heliographics. Heliographics is a sacred writing. Sacred writing means what? It is a symbol writing. Symbol writing in the sense, we don't know exactly what symbol writing. I just predicting that this is a symbol. This is a one more symbol. This is a symbol. You may have noticed, right? All these are symbolic. I don't know what symbol writing is, children. To just make you to understand, I'm telling. Such kind of a symbol writing has been found in the cave, or where the Egyptian civilization has found, the historian has noticed hieroglyphics, which means sacred writing, which has been noticed during the period of a Egyptian civilization. That has, I forgot, it will come for one more, children. Okay, hieroglyphics is a sacred writing, which means symbol writing, that has been observed by the historian during the time of a excavation. Then, and you can tell that this is a contribution of the Egyptian, and also Egyptian has introduced calendar system. That is one of the contribution of the Egyptian. Is it clear, children? Then they built many temple building that is the contribution of the Egyptian that will come to later. And here I am telling Osiris. Osiris is a god of life and death, and the concept was thought by the priest to the common people. And you can see there is a one more concept called mummy. What is a mummy? Mummy, I told, because here the Egyptian believed in the concept called life after death. Life after death, in the sense, if the person died, the soul will return again that body. That is called as a life after death. So here, as the mummy, what is a mummy? It is a preservation of a dead body. Preservation of the dead body is called as a mummy. Preservation of dead body. How they used to preserve dead body, children? They used to wrap those dead bodies with thin cotton cloth. They used to wrap the dead body with the thin cotton cloth. Before wrapping that dead body, they used to simmer, in the sense, applying some chemicals on the dead bodies. After applying or after simmering that chemical on the dead body, they used to wrap that dead body with the thin cotton cloth. After covering that complete dead body, they used to keep that dead bodies in a coffin. Coffin, you know, it is a box where dead body is to keep. So what is a mummy? Mummy is a method where preservation of a dead body can be seen. Where applying chemical on a dead body and covering that dead body with the thin cotton cloth. And that was called as a mummy. After the dead body was called as a mummy, and how they are preserving, after when mummy is ready, they used to keep that mummy on coffin. That was the earlier system, children, okay? And along with that coffin, they used to keep all the necessary things which is required for that dead body. You may thinking that after a person died, what he may require, isn't it, children? That is what we believe nowadays, isn't it? But in those days, I told, they believed in the concept called life after death. They assume that if the person, one who died with the good deeds, he will reborn and the soul again will join the same dead body. So that they used to preserve the dead body. So what they have to do, they have to keep everything, all those necessary things which is required for that dead body. They like comb they used to keep, then other barber item, they required for dead body they used to keep, then mirror, then other things, clothes, all everything which is required for one human being, that they used to keep along with the dead body. Before children, remember that before they used to keep the mummy inside the coffin, and those coffin or the graveyard which they used to construct it in Nile Valley itself. In the river valley itself, they used to construct the graveyard. Later on, as the civilization moved on, the Egyptian moved from northern side. When they moved to northern side, they found the deserted land they found. In the deserted land, they still continued the system of preserving dead body as a mummy. In the northern valley, they started to construct the pyramid. Is it clear? Before, they used to keep the dead bodies, mummies, in river valley itself. Later on, when Egyptian moved to northern side, they used to construct the pyramid. What is this pyramid? Pyramid is a, you may have seen in YouTube or any other communication media, pyramid in the sense, it is a triangle shape of a construction, or it is a tomb which was constructed by the Egyptian. It shows that how the skilled person these Egyptian are. It was very artisanal work which they are doing. So they used to keep the mummies. Instead of keeping a dead body in the coffin, they used to keep these dead bodies in a pyramid, which was highest in the sense, you may see that pyramid. The pyramid was constructed with the high blocks, stones. So it was a competition that whose pyramid will goes very high. So remember here children that I told you the concept about mummy as well as the pyramid. Even you should not forget that these mummy and pyramid were constructed only for royal families or for the emperor, not for the common man. Is it clear? That is why they used to construct the pyramid. Otherwise, for a common people or a simple people, who will construct or who will do such a huge investment, children? Here, these pyramid and mummies were constructed for Pallavas. Pallavas is nothing but emperor. When the emperor died, the people used to construct these pyramids in the hope that again he will reborn or the soul again will enter on the dead bodies. So even there is a competition that which king pyramid will be highest. They used to construct highest and highest pyramid than the existing one. So here Parava, what do you mean by Parava? Parava in the sense a person, one who lives in Palatine house which is very luxurious or the comfortable place and even which is located in a very high place. So Paroho in the sense he is the emperor who lives in a palatine house or the palatine place. So what we have learned, we learned today about Nile River which made the establishment of our Egyptian civilization and heliography. Then Osiris, a god of life and death. Then mummy and about pyramids and Parava, he is the emperor or one who lives in a palatine place. Then after the development of a Egyptian, how the administration or how the Egyptian civilization has been came into end. So up to here we have seen that the proper and prosperity of the Egyptian civilization. Then the prosperity of the Egyptian civilization has been attracted by shepherd person called Hypsis. This is a shepherd tribe. A person called Hypsis, what he will do? He was attracted by the prosperity of the Egyptian civilization. So he attacked the Egyptian civilization and he ruled the Egypt for 500 years. In the sense tribe, the Hypsis tribe which ruled the Egyptian civilization for 500 years. So the rule or the tribal shepherd tribe which ruled the Egyptian civilization for 500 BC. Then how the rule of these Hypsis tribe, they are very cruel. They used to loot the wealth of the people, Egyptian people. Then in this situation, the priest of the Jews, they left the Egypt and they went to the other place where they are can preach the knowledge. So what the happened? Jews were left the Egypt and they move on to other places so that they can help the people in administration. So where in the rule of a Hypsis tribe, Egyptian people has suffered so much of a loss both economically and politically, so that a person called Hebes, he will revolt against Hypsis tribe and he suppressed the rule of a Hypsis tribe and made Egyptian as a free. Again he made the Egyptian as a free. Then the next comes a rule of a Cambyses. What he will do? He is the king of Egypt. He ruled the Egypt, especially he is a Persian ruler. He ruled the Egypt normally as a well-known or a intact way. Later on, another person called Alexander. You may heard the name of Alexander. What is the aim or the ambitions of Alexander? Alexander wanted to conquer entire world, so that he was called as a Alexander the Great. In the sense, he wanted to defeat entire world and he wanted to rule as a single ruler for the entire world. He wanted to become a single ruler. So that what he has done, he has defeated the Cambyses, who is the Persian ruler in Egypt. He defeated the Persian ruler and made Egypt, which was ruled by the Persia, which he make a part of a Macedonia. I'll repeat once again. So see children here, after the when the Egyptian civilization was prosperous, it was attracted by the shepherd tribe, which was Phocases. He attacked the Egyptian civilization and he looted the prosperity of the Egypt, so that Jews, when they were there in Egyptian civilization, they left the Egypt and move on to other part of the world where they can help the ruler in administration. So during the rule of the Phocases tribe, the Egyptians suffered lot. Then later comes Thebes. He is a ruler of a, or he is a one who bring make a Egypt free in the free from the hands of a Phocases. It means that Thebes who liberated Egyptian in the hands of these Phocases. Then next comes Cambyses. He is a Persian ruler or the Persian Empire, one who ruled the Egypt. Again the Cambyses was defeated by the Alexander. Alexander defeated this Persian ruler and make Egypt as a part of Macedonia. Clear? When Alexander defeat the Cambyses, he made the Egypt as a part of Macedonia. And when Alexander defeated the Egyptian ruler or the Persian ruler, what he has done? He appointed one of his loyal person to rule this defeated part. Is it clear, children? When Alexander defeated the Persian ruler, he appointed his loyal person to look after the defeated place, and that loyal person created a city called Alexandria. He created the city called Alexandria in Egypt. Then later on, another important character will arise in Egypt, that was Cleopatra. I hope you heard the name Cleopatra. She is a very beautiful lady. She is a queen of Egypt. She ruled Egypt very bravely, because she is a very beautiful. Seeing her beauty only, emperor are scared to attack the Egypt. So having such a beautiful face, she fought against the enemies. And you may heard the name of a Caesar. He is a Roman Empire children. Roman Emperor. What he has done? Caesar is very powerful like a Alexander, but he was surrender himself to the beauty of a Cleopatra, so that he never attacked the Cleopatra. During the time of a Cleopatra, he never attacked the Egypt. But Caesar's son-in-law, that was Augustus. Who is Augustus? Augustus is a Julius Caesar son-in-law. What he has done? Unlike his father, he has not kept quiet. He attacked the Egypt and defeated the Egypt, and he decided to take Cleopatra along with him to the Rome. Is it clear? Augustus defeated the Cleopatra, the Egyptian queen, and decided to take Cleopatra along with him to the Rome. But what she will do? She will consume a poison and she committed the suicide. With the death of a Cleopatra, the end of a Egyptian civilization. Is it clear, children? So here, with the death of a Cleopatra, the end of a Egyptian civilization. Again, I want to summarize, children. In the ancient civilization of a world, today we refer Egyptian civilization, where we get to refer, because of the Nile River, the Egyptian civilization has came to establish. Then we can see, as a contribution of an Egyptian, they are contributed hieroglyphics, which means sacred writing or the symbol writing. Then their life, how the life of the Egyptian, they believed the concept called life after death. It means that when the person die, again he will come back. And they assumed the Osiris is a god of a life and death. When they believed the concept of a life and a death, they used to preserve the dead body with the method of a mummy. Then, to preserve that mummies, they constructed the pyramids. Then, their king was called as a Parova, which means a person, one who lives in a high, palatial place. Then, as an Egyptian civilization continued, the prosperity of the Egyptian civilization was attracted by the shepherd tribe, Arabian shepherd. They are clear, children? These hypotheses are the Arabian shepherd. They attacked the Egyptian civilization and they looted the wealth of the Egypt, and Egyptians suffered a lot in the hands of the Arabs. Then the Thebes, he will come to liberate the Egypt in the hands of a Hyksos tribe. Then next comes Cambyses. Cambyses is a Persian ruler. He ruled the Egypt. Then next comes Alexander. He is a conqueror, not the emperor of Egypt. He is a conqueror. He defeated the Persian ruler and made this Persia as a part of a Macedonia and created city called Alexandria by the loyal person of Alexander. Then the last queen was Cleopatra, who was defeated by the Augustus, who was a son-in-law of Julius Caesar. When Augustus decided to take Cleopatra along with him to the Rome, she committed the suicide. So here the end of a Egyptian civilization. We will meet in the next topic, which was Mesopotamia civilization. Till then, children, see you.